And now it's our final B-class fight of the evening in the 62 kilogram bracket. In the red corner, representing Stoke Tyre, Liam Griffin. Introducing his opponent, fighting out of Johnny T. Jim, Dave Gumley. Is the 11th fight of the evening, a B-class contest in the 62 kilograms bracket. On my right-hand side, and representing Stoke Tyre, Liam Griffin. And on my left-hand side, fighting out of the blue corner, representing Johnny T. Jim, Dave Gumley.
Gentlemen, come to the centre. Come to the centre, guys. Gentlemen, it's a B-class fight. You are allowed to knee to the head. You understand that? And you understand the rules. Protect yourselves at all times and have a fair fight, OK? Go to your corners. Good luck. Judge ready? Judge ready? Judge ready? Boxers, ready? Round one. Box.
So here we have a B-class fight, fight 11 on Muay Thai King Promotions. We've got Liam Griffin in the red corner from Stoke Tyre in the black shorts. And we have Dave Gumley in the white shorts in the blue corner from Johnny T's gym.
Now, Liam Griffin's looking really nice style there, like, and that's a beautiful left kick, he's southpaw as well.
Yeah, proper Muay Thai style that is, isn't it?
Really relaxed.
Now, I think Dave is an opponent that has stepped in on late notice. By the looks of it, he's really experienced.
Beautiful body kick by Liam Griffin there. Beautiful.
It says here that this is Liam's fifth fight. If so, he is looking so comfortable in the ring.
Very comfortable. And it's crazy that he's only 20 years old. The standard in the UK at the moment of Muay Thai, the young fighters are so good.
Yeah, I'm sure I've heard of his name before as well,
yeah,
you know.
I'm the same. I'm sure that name rings a bell. And they're from Stoke Muay Thai, who have had a few fights on tonight. And their fighters are getting better and better. So
yeah, traditional
exactly.
Thai style. That's what we like to say.
Oi, beautiful left kick.
Trading kicks in the first round again, testing each other out.
Liam looks like he's dictating this fight at the moment, but again, round one, you can never ever tell. But that left body kick is beautiful from Liam Griffin. Beautiful style.
That's what I mean, and if he carries it on, it's gonna take its toll on Dave. You can't keep taking that.
He's not just hitting the body either, he's hitting his arm as well with that kick. And that hurts sometimes even more than getting hit in the body, so.
Well, that's how you break someone's arm, isn't it?
Yeah, a shin on the arm is horrible. Great first round for Liam Griffin there. Beautiful style.
Yeah, that's what it's all about, isn't it? Bouncing back from things like that.
Exactly. That sometimes that shows that you're a true fighter, is when they bounce back from it and come back and show that they're not fazed. But
like I say, Stoke on Trent Muay Thai have had great fighters on tonight, so that helps, you know, all great fighters training together, you know, spurring each other on.
Definitely, yeah, it helps a lot, like, definitely helps a lot. And Liam Griffin is showing that they're setting a high standard in that gym because he's got a beautiful Muay Thai style.
Some nasty trading of low kicks.
They're both going for now, and I think Dave's coming back out. I think he had a quiet round one there. Maybe he's took it on late notice, and maybe that's kind of, he's trying to start off slow, so he's got energy in the tank on the later rounds. But
yeah.
Yes. Oh yeah, beautiful body kick there, back from a good block as well.
You can tell he's experienced by his composure.
Yeah, he is. He's really relaxed. He doesn't seem fazed by Liam. Liam's throwing some big kicks at him, but he doesn't seem fazed at the moment. So, yeah, you can tell he's experienced. Good head. I think that one just missed the head. Going through the middle with that left cross. We've seen, that's the second southpaw we saw today. We used that left cross straight down the middle, and it worked a treat on the orthodox fighters. It's working really well.
Them knees, when he brings them back and swings them in, are really effective. You know, the power there, and they look effective as well.
Yeah, definitely. Liam just looks so comfortable in there at the moment. And I think he just has a little bit too much for Dave at the moment. But again, who can tell? You can't tell when it's second round, but...
Yeah, no, I agree. He is looking strong towards the end of the round, which the judges will see last.
He's got his arm in Dave's face, Liam, and he's using that to his advantage in the clinch.
Really good technique, isn't it?
Beautiful. It'll be interesting to see Dave put the pressure on Liam, though. Stop letting him use that left kick and like stop working with that, because at the moment he's just letting Liam dictate the pace of the fight.
I think he came out fast at the beginning of the round, but then...
He slowed down a little bit there, yeah.
Yeah.
It happened to me on one of the Muay Thai Grand Prix, but they managed to find a last-minute replacement. I made the weight in the morning. I lost a lot of weight in the morning. Probably the most of everyone left. Yeah, my opponent didn't get into England, so...
Oh, yeah. That's a bit silly.
Yeah, so, yeah, but... Anyway, round three. Let's see how this pans out. Straight down the middle again from Liam. I'm really impressed with Liam in this fight.
Them knees and turns are wicked. Keeping them off balance and them swinging knees, they're effective.
Yeah.
Especially round the back, they will hurt.
Yeah, he's showing effect there. They've still not looking too phased. He's got a poker face, but he needs to start throwing and scoring back, because at the moment Liam is landing at will.
He's good with his boxing, Dave. He needs to use that a bit more.
Yeah, I think that's the way he needs to win, is pressure Liam now, because he's letting Liam dictate the pace. And Liam's got a slow tire style pace, but effective kicks. I think Dave needs to rush him a little bit and put the pressure on him now, close that distance.
Good head kick there by Liam.
Loving that jumping knee as well. Right round the back there again.
I could see that, and I didn't know if he was going to go for it, kicking that back leg.
He's the full package. He's used his hands, he's used his legs, he's used his clinched knees, he's using everything, Liam. He is, you know what, this is a star for the future, I think.
Yeah,
he is
100%.
He's looking wicked.
Especially when he's only had 5 fights, this is his 5th fight, sorry.
Exactly, and he's only 20 years old as well.
Bright future.
Definitely composed as well.
I mean, Dave's still in the fight, but for me, it seems like Liam is just working and scoring.
Definitely. We saw tonight as well where there's a fight, when they're fighting C or B class, where they're not as experienced, they try to start slow, but when someone's rushing forward, they kind of lose it and they go a bit messy. But Liam's not letting Dave do that to him today, and that's when it shows that he's fighting really well. And all of his fights, I can see him trying to get that Thai style technique,
and it's working.
Yeah, it's working really well tonight.
So you're doing a brilliant job. Keep it up.
I don't think any of his fighters lost tonight.
No, they've all won.
They've all won tonight.
And in style.
Yeah, they've done it well.
Wow.
Even good. Entertaining the crowd now with those knees again, jumping knees.
That's what it's about though when you fight. Obviously you want to win and you want to do well, but it's also, you're here to entertain the crowd.
Exactly.
And when you can do that, you'll be a top fighter. You know, just them little jumping knees that look good. They score well as well, but...
This is how people from the outside where they don't know about Muay Thai, when they see stuff like that, that's what they enjoy seeing, like those flashy techniques. So yeah, it's good to see people adding that into as well. Strong basics and flashy as well.
Yeah. And I think you only do that when you feel comfortable that you're winning. You don't dare do a move wrong if you're, you know, you're not in the run.
Definitely. That was a beautiful lean back there as well, and counter left low kick by Liam. You've got to give it to Dave though. He's a warrior. Another jump from Nido.
He's going to take that leg, do you reckon?
Yeah, he's going to take it.
The referee split it.
Box.
Big punches though. That is what Dave needs to do. He needs to pressure. Oi, lean back and kick there. Yeah, he needs to pressure Liam a lot more. It's harder saying that than doing, but I think if he does that, he'll make Liam struggle a little bit more. But Liam looks so comfortable and relaxing there. Oh, beautiful though. As we say that, Dave's just come under the leg and sweep. It's beautiful work.
He can hear you.
Beautiful punch though. It's like, he's come again, the sweep underneath.
That score as well as
now
well.
He's got confidence. Let's see what happens here then. And there we go.
That switch kick, left, right kick, that's really hard to do.
Massive heart from Dave there.
End of the round.
You know what?
I think he came through too late.
Too late, yeah, just a little bit too late. If he'd done that halfway through the round, he would have took the round, but Liam again took the round. I think that was a beautiful sweep, the first sweep. The second one again, and he got confident after that, which is good.
So here we are, the final round of this bout. It's been really good. Some great technique going on. Some great power.
Both of them want it. It's good to see. Both of them still want it. I think Liam just wants it a little bit more tonight, but.
Yeah, well, Liam's young and hungry. You know, he'll be feeling strong. In my opinion, he's won all four rounds so far. Yep. You know, and that always boosts your confidence.
This weight is 62 kilo. This is Liam is a force to be reckoned with in the UK at 62 kilo in the future, definitely.
Stop boxing, break.
Said to Liam, have you had any special preparations for this fight? And he just said, train hard, 110%. And that is someone that is young and hungry for it and wants to make waves. And that's what he's doing.
And he's just got an all-round game. I'm enjoying watching. He's good at everything, which is good to see.
And he's still, even though he's winning, he's still pushing forward.
Yeah, he's giving it for the crowd here as well. And so is Dave. So fair play to Dave. Hats off to him. But those knees must be taking effect now as well. They are. You can see the grimace on Dave's face.
Yeah, he's going to be a bit sore tomorrow.
Definitely. But he has stuck out the five rounds. He's took a bit of punishment today and he took on late notice. So.
Yeah, exactly. For a late notice opponent, he's done really well. There, he just keeps on coming forward. Referee breaks him up and he's forward.
Break! There you go, step back. Turn around.
I think Dave looks tired now.
He's just marching forward now, Liam. He still wants the knockout. He doesn't want to leave it to the point still. Beautiful sweep as well.
Yeah, that was good.
He still wants that win. He still wants that knockout win. I don't think he's going to get it because Dave is a tough guy, you know.
Do you know what? I think I've just seen the fighter of the night.
Yes.
There is actually trophies for that.
You know what? I think he has got to be up there. And you know what? I'm looking forward to seeing Liam Griffin fight in the future because that was a great performance.
Yeah, 100%. That was a wicked fight. Well done to both boys, but Liam Griffin, you will hear his name again.
Definitely, definitely well done.
And the judges have scored in favour of your winner. Unanimous decision in favour of your winner for the red corner, Liam Griffin. And some support for his opponent, Dave Gumley.
Thank you.